25 years after her death, the memory of this legendary sex goddess survives. But Marilyn Monroe remains a bittersweet memory for a man named Joe Jasgur. Because as Marilyn was on her way to stardom, Joe was one of those forgotten by the girl he knew as Norma Jeane.
In March 1946, a girl came over to me wanting to know if she'd get some photographs at no charge. She didn't have any money. And I said, don't worry, Norma Jeane, I'll get you some pictures.
These pictures made up Norma Jean's first modeling portfolio and helped pave the way to her success as Marilyn Monroe. Most have never been seen before. Now, 43 years later, they're on display in Hollywood.
Everybody comes in and says, God, she looks so wholesome. She looks so fresh. It's beautiful to see these, the way she used to look.
Joe Jasgur was a freelance photographer when he met 19-year-old Norma Jean Dougherty. Just about every week for 3 months, she posed for him at the beach and up in the Hollywood Hills.
And during that time, we had a ball. She was very willing to cooperate, anything I wanted. She was a good model in that respect.
The two clicked professionally and personally. Joe claims, in fact, he was propositioned and proposed to by Norma Jeane, even though she was married at the time.
For some reason, she wanted to prove that, I guess, she's irresistible and she could seduce any man she wanted or get him to do whatever she wanted to do, but I turned her down to marriage many, many times. I am probably one of the few people, believe it or not, that never went to bed with her. I know most people did.
According to Joe, this is a Marilyn before nose, teeth, chin, and breastwork, and of course, before blonde.
I told a friend of mine who was running a modeling agent, she may be a good girl, I said, but if we made her into a blonde, she would even be better, possibly.
We're just two little girls from Little Rock.
A new look, a new name, and soon Marilyn Monroe is on her way to screen immortality. And as Marilyn closed the door in her past as Norma Jeane, Joe Jasgur was one of those she shut out. Just months after Joe took his last shots of Norma Jeane, he ran into her at a movie premiere.
And I says, oh, hi, Marilyn. I says, remember me? She says, no, I don't think I do. Who are you? I says, you mean to say you don't remember Joe Jasgur, the fellow that got you started, gave you the first pictures, the guy you want to marry and everything else, and you don't remember me? She says, no, I don't think I do. So I said to myself, well, I didn't shoot a picture that night. I said, I'll never take another picture of her again. And I didn't.
Goodbye, no.
When I first knew her, she was a simple person in many, many ways. But as time went on, she became a little more complicated, a little more confused. And I don't think she knew what she wanted in life.
Joe's memories of Marilyn are still tinged with bitterness long after personal and professional pressures drove her to self-destruction. But a more wholesome and innocent time in Marilyn's life survives, captured in Joe Jasgur's images of young Norma Jeane. Like a candle in the wind.